It was the day after Thanksgiving in 1991 that I packed my bags and flew to Guantanamo Bay. And hence the story begins.
Some say history is nothing more than stories about what happened in the past. And what happened in the past is nothing more than a memory.
When I told people that I was going to Guantanamo to defend detainees, the standard joke was, well, don't work too hard.
I lived there during probably the most exciting time and the most dangerous time in American history, or maybe world history.
I lived down there during the days of Batista and then the days of Castro, the Bay of Pigs, and the missile crisis. And I lived down there during all four of those events.
Though it's been a U.S. naval base for over 100 years, Guantanamo remains shrouded in mystery.
Guantanamo was, I guess it still is, one of the best duty stations in the Navy.
And it was truly, paradise.
You have beautiful coral reefs.
A swimming pool.
A school there for the kids.
Diving or snorkeling.
We had Girl Scout brownies.
A McDonald's.
Taco Bell.
So you have, you know, all the comforts of home in one sense, and then you have this very high security prison complex where a lot of very unpleasant things have gone on.
What you hear on the news is always just kind of, oh, it's bad, it's a bad place, it's this and that, and you get down there, and then you kind of get a history of what all's happened on that base throughout the year.
History isn't just recorded, it's lived. This is the story of Guantanamo and the people who lived its history.
I thought that the detention centers and the camps would be a larger part of life here, but really you can live here and totally not hear anything about the camps.
The first person that we met when we got off the plane was a humongous Marine. So I didn't have any concerns at all about my safety from that point on.
There was an extremely large amount of tanks going down the road, a lot of Marines with machine guns.
Marines came around to each house with a message, and the message said higher authority has deemed it necessary for dependents to be evacuated from the base immediately.
And they were just one after another, so we were like, something's going on, but we don't know what.
As the historical epicenter of major world events, Guantanamo isn't without controversy.
Guantanamo was selected precisely because the Bush administration believed it was a place that was beyond the reach of the law.
What many people in America don't know, or haven't heard, or haven't learned, is that the vast majority of the people in Guantanamo were innocent.
And it did cross my mind that I could have killed them if I wanted to. I had all this anger. But you spend a few minutes with somebody, and you view them as a human being. You know, it was kind of like an emotional train wreck.
Totalmente. Te digo, hice buenos amigos entre los soldados. Y nos trataban como amigos. Al principio nos trataban con guantes y con tapabocas. Como éramos emigrantes, veníamos de un lugar distinto. No sabíamos si traíamos enfermedades. Y ya después tomaban el mismo vaso que nosotros dos.
If you read the news or you watched TV, you got a very distorted picture of what was going on. All around the camps, we had concertina wire just as a crowd control kind of a thing. But it made it look like Auschwitz because they'd shoot through the wire and you've got these Haitians and these little kids and this concertina wire.
Though historians may debate Guantanamo's impact on world history, there is no question that Guantanamo has left an indelible mark on everyone was crossed its borders.
My name is etched in the history of Guantanamo. And my role as the Muslim chaplain is now part of history.
When I came home from there, I had a true sense of freedom.
At the end of the day, when I left there, I could say I did good for the people who were there.
Guantanamo was by far the most important professional experience that I've had in my career. It was an opportunity for me to stand up for values that I believed in very deeply.
I absolutely loved it when I lived there. And I guess I still, in my mind, want to remember it like it was when I was a child.
People don't really realize how much they miss this place until they leave it, because you can't come back.
I would go back and do it again. If they let us go do it again, I'd go back in a heartbeat.
These are the memories of Guantanamo.